Hi, this is Tutor Nick P, and this is Proverbs 239. The proverb today is sell in May and go away. Okay, let's take a look at the note here. The proverb is often used in reference to the stock market or investments in commodities, securities, etc. Okay, if you have ever done any research about buying stocks, you may be familiar with this term. This phrase is sometimes also said as sell in May and stay away. So it could either be sell in May and go away or sell in May and stay away. The idea is that stocks, commodities, investments are more likely to increase in value in the months from November through April. You know, there could be a Christmas rally or a New Year's rally. Of course, there are many exceptions to this rule, so you still have to do your research. Or remember, I just did the article on due diligence. You still have to do your own due diligence and look at each stock you buy. But in a general sense, like if you were buying stocks for the first time getting into the stock market, maybe late October might be the better time to do it. But the individual stocks you pick is probably still more important. Another similar proverb that has nearly the same meaning is buy when it snows and sell when it goes. So it's the same idea, you know, from that November through April time period tends to be the better time period for, you know, investments in these areas. Okay, and we just have a couple of examples to cover this. Here's the first one. Some studies show that there is a lot of truth to the proverb sell in May and go away. Like if you did that from year to year, you know, chances are you should be ahead again. You know, if you use at least a little research and don't pick stocks that are too terrible, you know, it's maybe some of the blue chips or something, you might stay ahead. All right, anyway, and here's the second one. Some investment analysts may encourage investors to sell in May and go away. According to this theory, the time to re-enter the stock market should be like in late October, because at that point, you know, they would have sold off the whole way. And that's just when people are coming back in. A lot of these investors sometimes take a lot of long breaks and vacations during the summer. Their kids are off and things like that. So they get back into the market usually, you know, later in the fall. So that's the idea. Okay, anyway. I hope you got it. Again, I hope you found it very informative. Thank you for your time. Bye-bye.